Holidays. I am Durga and this is my first video of 2021. For past 2 weeks, Shalmani has been making beautiful things. First, she made a fridge magnet and second one was her 2021 calendar. And for this video, we are going to make dream catcher. So dream catcher comes from an American native culture. It's nothing but a handmade woven willow hoop. Uske piche bahut sare sacred myths hai. But irrespective to that, I think it's a beautiful home decor. Market में बहुत सारे बहुत प्यारे प्यारे dream catchers मिलते हैं, but DIY की बात ही कुछ और है. So let's make our dream catcher. So the first thing you need for a dream catcher is a ring. So you get this size dream catcher ka ring aram se in the market, but mujhe specific measurements ke chahiye the, to maine aisi market se tar li and then ek bahut hi bhale welder ne mujhe ye weld bhi karke di. So this one is the smallest one which I have and iska diameter hai around 10 inches and then I have a middle one which is 15 in diameter and then I have a bigger one which is 20 in diameter. So I got this metal tar and got all these rings made from a welding person. Now the first thing we are going to do is I'm going to wrap this ring with a white string. So we will start by making a knot over here and then we will wrap around this whole ring with this white string. And I will come back by wrapping all these three rings. Finally, we are done wrapping white thread around the ring. It does take a lot of time, so keep patience. The first ring we are going to work is the larger one. So I'm going to hang it on here. And then I have taken this white jute rope which I have wrapped around this stick so that it's easy for us to work on. And the first thing we do is we will make a double knot anywhere on the ring. So we make a double knot and then we will start making a design on our dream catcher. So we'll start wooing. So the first thing we'll do is we'll make a knot right where we have made our first knot. So I'm just putting first knot over here and then I'll go down around and pull it from the loop like this. So we have one loop over here. Again, we'll go down around and pull it from the loop. So we have to make sure that the distance between both these knots is equal. So just pull it tight. And now I'm going to time lapse this whole thing. And once I finish here, I'll show you how to connect it to the first loop.
I have reached on the end of this first round. For the second round, again we have to do the same thing. We have created this loop, so we have to just pull our thread down, around, and pull it from the loop like this. So we have to make sure that the knot is in the center, and then we'll do it again. Put it down, around, and pull it through. Again, put a knot in the center and see. This is the web kind of design that has been created, and I'm going to repeat this all around. And I'm going to do 3 to 4 rounds of this rings, and then we will attach another ring.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just add this ring right now in the center of this larger ring. so that we know ki how much design we want to make. And now we know that we just want to make one more round of this larger ring. So now I think this is enough for the larger ring. I'm just going to close it. So I'm just going to secure this knot with another knot at the end and cut it. Now we will start working on the middle ring. So I'm going to create the same design on the middle ring as well. So two of our rings are done. Now is the time to work on the third and the smallest ring. So let's do that. Well, for the smallest ring, I have decided to make a tree of life. Main blue or white color ke threads use karne wali hun. We start by cutting 9 strands of white. These are all of 50 inches. And similarly, I'll cut 17 of blue strands of 15 inches each. I'm going to go white to blue. So first I'll tie a pair of white strand with a lark knot. Just double your strand, put it beneath the ring and pull the thread from its own loop. Let's tie all the 26 strands in the same manner and we will come back once it's done. Now all the strands are tied up. If you'll see, we have started with two pairs of only white threads and then moved on with 5 pairs of white and blue strands. Last, I have tied 6 pairs of only blue. So the white will gradually get to blue. We have to make sure ki har ek do threads ke beech mein gaps hai. Let's start working on the first pair of a white thread. We have total of 4 white strands here. I'm going to make a spiral knot. For that, first make a loop with the rightmost strand on the top of other 3 strands and then pull the leftmost strand from beneath all the threads and the loop. Then pull both the threads from each side and this is our first knot. We keep doing that from right side and then we will have a series of spiral knots. I am going to make at least 15 of them on each of the 26 pairs. These are going to be our twigs for our tree of life. Now that our twigs are ready, let's move on to make our branches. I'm going to join 2 of these twigs with spiral knot again. Let's do that with 15 spiral knots. Once that is done, we will have to extend its neighboring twig, which we will join with this branch. Now this twig is extended. Let's join this with the earlier branch. And then we'll do the same with the neighboring twig as well. So we have made these branches with 4 twigs. Now let's make 3 such branches with 3 twigs each. Finally, all our branches are done. I have gone ahead and joined few of the branches too. Now let's start making our trunk. Again, we will make a spiral knot, but this is going to be very thick so it won't spiral. Take the rightmost strand and tie it with the leftmost strand. We will have to do at least 25 of these. And with this, our tree trunk is ready too. Let's move on and attach our roots. All we need to do is tie the loose strands to the ring and we will be all done. And here it is, a beautiful, strong, stable tree of life is all ready.
Okay, so our small ring is ready too. Now all we need to do is attach it to the middle ring and then we will start making our tassels.
Now we will retie both the rings so that they can move independently. We just need to tie the ring to the string which is just above it. Taki wo ring freely move hogi aur kahi atkegi nahi. Let's tie our tree of life as well in the same way. And then we will tie a hanging string to this and move on to make our tassels. I'm going to hang our dream catcher on a wall and add strings to it with a lark knot again. There is no fixed rule as to how much or how long the tassel should be, So I'll just stop when I feel enough. I'm just trying to give these hanging threads a U kind of shape so that it will look proportionate and neat. The last and the most fun step is to add beads and feathers. I feel like Dreamcatcher is incomplete without them. So just thread the beads and glue the feathers at the end. And with that, our wonderful Dreamcatcher is complete.
Well, this brings us to the end of our Dreamcatcher video. I always wanted to make one and I attempted a triple oar because ये जो swirling effect है उसे देखने में बड़ा मजा आता है. But अगर आपको ये तीन ring वाला नहीं बनाना है, you can make a single ring one as well. वो भी बहुत प्यारा लगता है. And मैंने ये काफी minimal और simple रखा है. But you can add as many beads or feathers or colors as you want. और अगर आप ये ट्राई कर रहे हैं तो डोंट फॉरगेट टू टैग अस ऑन इंस्टाग्राम. वी आर डैफी ड्रीम्स ऑन इंस्टाग्राम टू. और अगर कोई क्वेरी है तो वी आर जस्ट अ कमेंट और अ मैसेज अवे. इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज गिव अस अ बिग फैट थम्स अप एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो एंड कमेंट एंड टेल अस हाउ डिड यू लाइक इट. प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग. बाय बाय.